in campaigning, one of the things you do is try to find out where the constituents are, and you do polls. And one of the things you also do is try to find out how those folks might react to certain bits of information that might be out there. My opponent, for example, has taken any number of shots at me, many of which are untrue. I'm not going to go through them in line item detail right now. That's the nature of a campaign. You'll notice and look at our campaign and what we've put out and what we're focusing on. We're focusing on the positive needs for the 21st Congressional District in the state of Texas. We're focusing on healthcare freedom. We're focusing on spending. We're focusing on strong national defense, border security, making sure we stop amnesty. We're focusing on all the things that I've been doing in my history and track record of fighting for the people of this district. And everything that we're putting out, everything we're doing in commercials, you'll see some commercials soon, hear some commercials on radio, all of the mail that you're seeing us put out is going to stay focused on that. But information is valuable. There is some information out there. There's no secret that my opponent is a government contractor. I'll tell you that the reason that we wanted to know about the response on that was because when my opponent makes charges about me and my career, having been a public servant for part of my career, after half of my career being in the private sector, half of my career in the public sector, I thought it was important to understand, and for constituents, voters to understand, that my opponent has built his business in significant part of government contracting. Now, I don't begrudge that, I'm gonna be honest with you, that's fine. But it is important to put side by side that truth with the truth of my history and my experience. I'm happy to stand on my track record. Excuse me?
Your questions, not you, but the campaign, not making the whole story aware to the person they're talking to. So you're making it insinuating things.
So the last point I'll make on that is, you ask questions in a push poll to find out where folks stand. And that's all that was for. But you'll see what we're putting out. We're not focusing on those things. We're not focusing on those issues. You can't put the whole story in a question that you ask. You're just trying to ask and see where the voters are on issues and those kinds of things. I know what I believe and I know what I'm running on. I know what I've been fighting for. Against amnesty, against gun registry, for lower spending, stopping earmarks, working side by side with Ted Cruz, Mike Lee, Louie Gohmert, Mark Meadows, Jim Jordan, conservatives trying to fight, working alongside Rick Perry to stop Medicaid expansion, to stop Race to the Top and No Child Left Behind expansion in Texas. These are all proven things that I've been doing. Federal prosecutor putting people behind bars, deporting illegal immigrants. And that's my track record, and I'm happy to stand behind that.
I was at a gun show last Sunday, and I had one of my very first employers walk up to me, and he almost didn't want to shake my hand, and he said, "Matt, I need to know, have you been lying to me, or was the person on the phone last night lying about you?" I've known Frank Dillingham since I was 16 and worked in his machine shop. And I said, "Well, Frank, what did they say?" And he said, "Well, they insinuated that you're a liberal and you don't support Trump." Really? So they're calling up 80-year-old people and distorting the truth. They know what they're doing. This isn't just cool. It's not just a tactic. It's sleaze. We know what the issues are at this point. You know, telling people, one set of questions was, are you aware that Matt, if you were aware that Matt McCall received $200,000 from the federal government, would that affect your vote for him? And another, they asked another person, if you were aware that Matt McCall received $1.2 million from the federal government, would that affect your vote for him? I'm a federal government contractor. They get billed right after they get the product. And I have an unusual business. I have an FDA-certified human tissue bank, and I provide human tissue for transplants to the American military hospitals in Europe and in Asia. So I spent the last 15 years taking care of soldiers from Afghanistan and Iraq to Landstuhl and from Lake and Heath to North Africa and in Asia. And I'm very, very proud of the work that I do. I beg to differ with my opponent who says that I have lied about it. I have not. He doesn't live in the district and he says he's not moving in. Those are facts. Check the voter rolls. That's not a lie. That's a simple fact. I have quoted the Dallas paper about when he left office working with Attorney General and the circumstances. And they say some very interesting things, and he was a private person, and if it was defamation, he could have sued them as defamation, but they doubled down on it and he didn't sue them. The record hasn't been corrected. I don't think it can be corrected. I think what they said was true. So, I'm sorry that that's happening. Hopefully you didn't receive one of those phone calls, but that's what's going on.
Are we having equal time, man?
For clarification on that, two things. That was 5 minutes against one candidate. One candidate responded to the accusation, and then his opponent reinforced the question. I don't think that's right. So if somebody wants to ask a question, or a supporter of Chip wants to ask a question, I'll entertain that. But I want to keep, and I've always done this, and I'm not endorsing, I don't endorse people. I want to keep it positive. I want to see what the candidates are going to do for us when they get to Washington. And I'm not too much interested in arrows and slings being thrown. So go ahead.